Carolina. It's freezing cold. I mean freezing. Like, it don't make no sense how cold it is down here. Like, really. I'm here in Florence. About to head up to Michigan. Well, I was going to head up to Michigan, but now they've got me about to swap some, swap Lowe's out with someone else. And now I'm going to head up to Chicago. I didn't want to go to Chicago. But it's fine. So, yesterday, well, let me back up. So, y'all know my truck was out for a whole week because my shifter went out. So, they fixed the shifter, right? And they give me my truck back. Why is all my power out in the back? My tri-pack don't work? Well, let me not say that. It worked when it wanna work. Like, I froze yesterday. I froze the day before that. Like, when I turn the truck off, you know I keep my tri-pack on all the time. Turn the truck off, go back there, turn my heater and stuff on, and it comes on, right? I hear the tri-pack running and stuff. But then it's like it just conk out. Ain't got no power back there. None of the outlets work. The little car charger piece they got, that stuff don't work. Don't nothing work back there. And, you know, I hit up breakdown. They talking about, you know, reset the truck. Start, you know, turn the battery off, turn it back on. Of course it still didn't work. So I was cold last night and the night before that, you know. And I was going to get a hotel room, but I didn't even want to be difficult, you know. I didn't want to hit them up like, y'all better give me a hotel room, you know. I ain't do all that, so. But, you know, I just kind of dealt with it. I got a lot of, you know, clothes here for cold weather, so I just kind of bundled up. But, all of a sudden, while I froze last night for many hours, I get up this morning because I'm an early bird person. And why did my tri-pack all of a sudden come on and now my heater want to work? I don't understand. I think this truck got something against me. They don't want me to make no money. They want me to freeze. It don't make no sense. This really don't make no sense. So my tri-pack back on, but my outlets still don't work. I have no power in my outlets. So I'm having to plug everything up in my inverter to like cook me food and stuff like that. It got to go on my inverter because I don't know what happened. And so we checked the fuses or whatever. I had the man at the shop check the fuses for me. What is this man doing? Anywho, so I had the man at the shop check the fuses. I call myself checking. You know, there's a lot of fuses over there trying to look and see which one is which and all that. Check both of them. And they, it's not the fuse, it's something else. And I don't know what it is, but it need to be fixed because I need to cook my food and I'm tired of having to plug up to my inverter and put my stuff down here on the floor. I just... Is driving amazing since he put that new shifter in there. He is driving amazing. Like, I'm so happy because normally when I would drive him, I'm gonna say it would take me like 30 seconds to even build up my speed to get to 30 miles per hour. So sad, right? Oh, it ain't like that now. Boy, I'm loving it. Loving it. They fix my outlets. But I'm gonna go put my truck in the shop again. Cause I'm finna go on hometown. Going home. I'm only going for 2 days. Cause my birthday's coming up. My birthday is December 23rd. So I'm going home So I'm gonna go put my truck in the shop and have them, you know, look over the things that's not working, you know, and see what's going on. Wash my truck and all that good stuff like that before I get back on the road. Kind of excited. But yeah, I just want to tell you guys what was going on, because this truck is crazy. But other than that, the miles looking good, chicks looking good, all that good stuff like that. Oh, another thing. Y'all, I'm doing so much better with my fuel. So much better. Yeah, so much better. So, I did an 1,800 mile load, which I don't understand. I've been trying not to, you know. I try and get most of the loads they give me, you know. But, some of the loads, I just don't understand. Some of these loads should be for team drivers. Why they giving us solo drivers 1,800 mile loads? I don't even be feeling like I'm doing no progress because I'm on a load for a couple days, you know. But, you know, whatever. So, I did an 1,800 mile load. And I just filled up again for the second time. Filled it up, got 85 gallons. Or ladies feet or something like that. And I just filled up again. Man, I'm about to ride this all the way to Ohio, where I'm going to go swap these loads out with this guy. And I'm gonna shut down here. About 500 miles away. So, I'm gonna shut down there, and then when I get up in the morning, I'm gonna head out into Chicago. So, yeah, you know, I'm doing a lot better with fuel. I'm doing better, you know. I'm having a little bumps and bruises along the way, but, you know, that's a part of trucking, you know. Everything not gonna be peaches and cream. You know, with time and experience, things get better. You learn to be able to handle things better, you know. But yeah, so anybody have any questions? I like to say that if y'all have any questions, feel free to hit me up. My number is 229-288-6922. If I don't know the answer, I will find it out and I will get back to you. If you interested in joining or coming over to the company, hit me up. I can get you on board. Yeah. They have a refreshers course if anybody is wondering about that. Because I have a couple questions about that. They do have a refreshers course. Purchase program. It is a no credit check and no money down program. Or you can drive team. So, yeah. Any more questions, hit me up. Comment below. Have a great day.